How you doing, folks? Shane Jenkinson here. I'm the PGA Professional at St. Margaret's Golf Club. And I'm going to give you a quick tip here. There's a little practice drill you can do on the putting green. Now that they're back open, you get a few minutes before your tee time. So what I've done here is I've picked myself about 4 or 5 footer, but I've picked a nice right to left break, and it's not a flat putt. So what I'm going to do is I've set up 3 tees here. I've set up a green, a blue, and a red one just outside the hole. And I've set up my starting point. So the starting point stays the exact same. So what I've done is the green, I'm going to start off by hitting at the green tee. That's going to be my aim point for the first one. And because I'm not aiming as far right as the other ones, I have to hit that one a bit firmer. It's not going to take as much break as the other ones. And then the blue one, again, is about 1.5 inches outside it. Again, you hit it a bit softer. It's going to curve a bit more because the pace isn't, there's not as much pace on it. And the red one, again, is going to be a dying pace. It's going to fall in the front door, hopefully. So this just shows you the relationship between aim and pace. Instead of just picking, you hear people saying like, oh, it's a cup outside the hole. It can be a cup outside the hole, but it depends on the pace. So pace is a bigger indicator of break than just where you're aiming. So what I'm going to do here, I'm going to start, I'm going to aim at the green one. So this is the one I'll have to hit a bit firmer than the other ones. Right, off to a good one. So we'll go with the blue one. So I'm going to have to pace this one down a little bit. I'm not going to hit it as firm. Right, so you see that one probably took a little bit more curve than the green one because it was less pace. And now we're on the red one, so I'm aiming a good 6 and a bit inches outside the hole. And this is going to curve and hopefully die into the hole. Right, so there we go. There's 3 different putts at a 3 different pace, 3 different speeds, sorry, and 3 different aim points. So might be only a short putt, but there's loads of different ways you can hold it. So it just gives you a bit of kind of a broader understanding of what the ball will do depending on pace and aim. So give this a shot. It's a good little practice drill. And if you have any questions, don't be afraid to ask. Thanks.